Hi there, it's Life Prepper here. I want to talk to you. Something pretty serious. You know, I've been going through a lot, and I want to tell you, being a depressant did not turn me into a prepper. I battle with depression every day. When there's those days, I just crawl in a hole. I don't want to come out. I don't want to leave my room. I don't want to leave the bed. I don't want to go to work. I don't want to leave the house. It's an ongoing battle. But being a depressant did not turn me into a prepper. Probably actually helped me see things in many aspects of things. I'll have to admit that. I went through so much trials and tribulation in my life. And those of you that watch my videos from the beginning and see me grow along with it, see me with the struggles of things, has seen me from not being able to walk. You know, I had a knee replacement, to gain a massive amount of weight from just, you know, and severe depression setting in where I wouldn't leave my room hardly. I wouldn't leave the house when I wasn't working. I had to force myself to go to work. I physically became sick, physically throwing up sick at the idea of having to leave the house on that. So dealing with a depression is not easy. It never is. And people, when I get out, most people see this happy-go-lucky, wisecrack, strong, independent woman out there in the workforce and around people as a general rule, because I tend to shut myself away. But the prepper lifestyle was always within me. I grew up around kinfolks that was country folks, basically, or lived the old ways, that did their own canning, did their own hunting, did the outdoors and stuff. So I was exposed to all of this. I was exposed to the knowledge that was there. But like so many people, life got chaotic. I went different routes. I got away from what I knew. I got away from it because when you get involved with other people in your life, and if they're not in that type of lifestyle that you grew up in, you get away from it. And then there's this hole in you. I mean, you know, for years I did so much stuff by myself because there really wasn't people out there to really enjoy what I wanted to do with. I mean, there were people that we did things, but for years I got away from what I really loved doing, and that was nature. I went caving and did other things with friends, but then it got to the point where I didn't have a mood, started over. It was just me, myself, and I. So the prepper lifestyle was always there. The knowledge that I learned from my kin folks, from people I grew up with, the knowledge was there just for me to reach out and to take. And more I seen on TV, the more I read, the more changes made me think more about getting back to the lifestyle that I knew, that I grew up with, to learn. Now, like I say, some of you have been with me since day one, you're going to check some of my videos, you're going to see where I gained massive amount of weight. You're going to see where I look really miserable because I was living in one room in my house, basically. The house needed so much work on it. And I would hibernate in one room during the winter months, and the rest of the house was shut off. I was using a hot plate to survive. But, you know, all the struggles I went through in this house, from having to collect rainwater to hauling in water to living in one room to cooking off a hot plate to, making do with what I could afford to do with, made me even stronger in many ways, I would say. Not saying that I'm not still depressed, I am. Right now, I'm very depressed. I'm very sad. I just want to give up. I want to sit there and cry. You know, and I want to fall apart. I want to take my backpack, load it up, whatever, and just walk away from everything and start walking. And end up wherever I end up at, walk away from my job, walk away from my home, walk away from everything, and just say, enough's enough. Now, that's not easy when you live like that day to day. You know you can, you know that's there. But at the same time, prepping is my choice to learn how to take better care of myself, to overcome things, to be able to become more focused. I can stay in my room and I can feel sorry for myself and let the depression totally engulf me and destroy me piece by piece. And it's done a pretty good job many times over the years. Now, I've worked hard to get most of my weight back off. I'm working hard to take better care of myself. But the depression is still there. I got up this morning and I was just really so depressed. And I just, you know, I'm going through personal trials and tribulations. And I need prayer to get through these things. And yes, I believe in God. And God is my strength. Now, I'm plain spoken. I say what's on my mind. And God knows that. But I also know God sends me where he wants me. And he's done all this for a reason. To teach me how to survive. So being a depressant was not the reason I became a prepper. I became a prepper because it was a need. Not necessarily a lifestyle. And I made my share of mistakes and like many newbies and bought things I didn't need to do, try to figure things out, try to learn things. Newbie mistakes. But each day I'm trying to do what I think is right and back to basic prepper lifestyle. Will the depression still remain? Yes. Will I have to battle it? Yes. Well, there'll be days I just want to give up and put that backpack on and walk out that door and never be seen or heard again. Yes. It will continue. There's days I feel like everybody would be so much better off without me. I mean, my trials and tribulations are overwhelming. My heart, just, if I could turn my emotions off, I would do it. But being a depressant was not the reason I became a prepper. I became a prepper because it was always there. The knowledge of it in back of my head, the fact is I had my own nature lab when I was a child. I had my own little workshop where I collected soda bottles and things. I also was taught how to make things. I learned how to fish. I was taught how to hunt. I know how to do countless things. So the prepper lifestyle was already there. Being a depressant was not the reason I became a prepper. Being depressant is something that's part of me that I had to learn how to deal with. And it's not easy. Like I said, today is one of my bad days. Today is one of the days that I just want to crawl in a hole and give up. So I can't allow that to totally happen. I've got to keep going. And part of it is as a prepper lifestyle is also being aware that being a depressant is something I have to deal with in a prepper lifestyle. I cannot allow this here to destroy me. I cannot allow myself to just give up and put a backpack on and walk out there and live on the streets. I can't allow that to happen because it'll destroy everything that I've done. Do I need money? Oh, Lordy, I do. Do I want to put a donate button on this thing? People say so I should. You know, maybe you ought to put a donate because for your videos. Crossed my mind, but no. Would I love to get some money? Sure, it would make so much difference. I got a house I'm trying to fix with no money, and I'm trying to get it sold. I'm looking at other states I can move to. Alaska is something I want to take, and it's really seriously thinking about going to live up there in nature, but it takes money to do that. Do I want to travel so I can do my YouTube and share my knowledge with people out there on what from prepping lifestyles to non-prepping lifestyles? There's many things I want to do, but also every day I have to battle this depression that I have within me, this sadness, this hole within me. It's a disease. It's a sickness, and it tears me apart many a day, and it's tearing me apart now. So becoming a prepper doesn't mean you got to be depressed, and a depressant doesn't make a prepper. It's not a lifestyle, it's a choice. So, this live prepper here, if you want to send some prayers my way, that's great. Maybe you can send some prayers my way and some money will come my way. It'd be nice there. But if I don't get a dime sent my way, you know, that's good too. You know, God just decided I didn't need no money right now. I just need to be tough and teach me more about how to survive. So this is a live prepper here. I want you to be safe, be happy. Bless you all.